This is CBS.
Fruity little Skittles are fun to chew. Some for me and some for you.
Hi, Bill.
Hi, Suzanne. What are you doing?
I'm eating Skittles fruit chews. I crunch the outsides and chew the insides. They feel real good in my mouth.
Yeah, they taste all fruity.
I love the colors. Lemon, orange, brown, strawberry, lime, purple.
Give me an orange one.
Fruity little Skittles are fun to chew. Some for me and some for you.
Come to the honeycomb hideout.
Honeycomb's big.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not small.
No, no, no.
Honeycomb's got a big, big bite.
A good breakfast featuring honeycomb gives you a big bite.
What's the prize?
A monster mint.
Is mine creepy?
Creepy.
How do you do?
How do you do?
One in each specially marked box of post-honeycomb cereal.
Wrench.
Wrench.
Socket.
Socket.
Plugs.
Motor.
Tires.
Chassis.
Spade bogey.
That's me. They raced it.
Antifreeze in my carburetor. Yeah. Yeah.
Speed buggy.
The Sunshine Family Band with its piggyback shack and the Sunshine Family making tracks. Coming to the country fair for crafts and things that you're making there. Make a swing for baby and aren't you glad that you could make a belt for dad. Next weekend there's a different plan for the Sunshine Family Van.
The Sunshine Family with Craft Book is sold separately. The Sunshine Family Van comes with Craft Book and piggyback shack that you put together. New from Mattel.
When your kids are away from you, too often they forget your good advice and fill up between meals.
That's why we're here.
Flintstones chewable vitamins with 6 flavors, 7 shapes.
And 10 essential vitamins.
It's the Flintstone way to help make sure kids get vitamins they could be missing.
So do what you can to help them eat well.
Hey, that's my favorite.
And help make sure of vitamins with Flintstones.
That's why we're here.
Regular or with iron.
Jerry Jones, David Cassidy, and the rest of the Partridges are here on KTTV when KTTV presents the Partridge Family.
Let the good times.
Oh, what is it, Mom? Laryngitis?
No, dear. I have a sinking feeling your brother's becoming a man.
Yeah?
His voice is changing.
Changing? That means my career is over. I'm wiped out.
Together. It's music and fun for everyone when David Cassidy and Shirley Jones lead the Partridge Family and send super entertainment. See it weeknights at 6 on Channel 11, where there's always more to see.
This is CBS.
On to McDonald's! Who's the McFriendliest fellow in town? Who's our McFavorite hamburger clown? Whose feet are funniest? Whose smile is sunniest? Ronald McDonald. Who's
from McRae, best McCown of all. In the spring, summer, winter, and fall. Whose tricks are trickiest? Whose mind is quickiest? Ronald McDonald!
Come to the honeycomb hideout.
I'm Big Betty, and I'm tired of small cereals, so give me one with a big bite.
Honeycomb's big,
and it's got a big bite.
Right. Honeycomb's part of a balanced breakfast, and it gives you a big bite.
A wacky roller printer inside.
Put it together.
Ink it.
Roll it.
Footprints.
Look at the footprints.
Wow, far out.
Three wacky roller printers, one in each specially marked box of Post Honeycomb cereal.
Cartoon characters, famous places, sports. I got someone right here.
With the reels out of the packets. Now, find the cartoon characters.
I found that on Duck.
Popeye and Scooby-Doo. Bugs Bunny.
What about you?
Is Washington Monument a cartoon character?
GAF Viewmaster. Over 500 three-reel packets available. All purchased separately.
Bonnie and I work in this Cocoa Pebbles factory.
Surrounded by all these chocolatey goodies.
Yeah, Cocoa Pebbles are chocolatey goodies. Yabba-dabba chocolatey-do.
I woke up this morning with something chocolatey on my mind.
And you came to work and got a good breakfast featuring Post Cocoa Pebbles cereal.
Chocolatey goodies everywhere.
Fred, I've got a desire for something chocolatey.
Have Cocoa Pebbles, Wilma.
Oh, yeah. Cocoa Pebbles are chocolatey goodies.
Yabba-dabba chocolatey-do.
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We got some work to do now. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We need some help from you now. Come on, Scooby-Doo, I see you. Pretending you got a sliver. You're not fooling me, cause I can see the way you shake and shiver. You know we got a mystery. Don't hold back. And Scooby-Doo, if you come through, you're gonna have yourself a Scooby snack. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, here are you. You're ready and you're willing. If we can count on you, Scooby-Doo, I know we'll catch that feeling.
This is CBS.
It's time for bed.
Well, that's easy for you to say.
Avast! You just speak in time.
Come on, guys. It's time to go to sleep.
We can't sleep.
We need some cookies.
It's your turn to get the cookies, you know, Ronald.
It always is. Luckily, McDonald's now has delicious cookies. They're crispy and crunchy and fun to eat. They come in the shapes of your favorite McDonaldland friends.
I'll trade you two Big Macs for a Captain Crook.
You're not worth it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Not again.
Now we can't sleep with the moon shining in our eyes.
It's your turn to put out the moon, Ronald.
It always is.
Shh. McDonaldland cookies are at McDonald's.
Dogging it up, right high on a curl. Not thinking about I'd be meeting a girl. Then wham, I met, but that fall wasn't all. In a bottle was a chick, only 2 inches tall. out came Jeannie.
Wow!
And Junior Jeannie Babu.
Master?
Betty's got strawberry-flavored marshmallows.
Fruit!
Fruit Brute, with a howling good taste of fruit.
Hey, Snoopy, wake up. It's time to brush our teeth.
Good grief, it's time to brush your teeth with your Snoopy toothbrush. Brushing right makes you smile bright with your Snoopy toothbrush.
Snoopy makes you want to brush your teeth.
Good grief, it's time to brush your teeth.
It's fun to brush your teeth with Snoopy.
Happiness is a battery-operated Snoopy toothbrush by Kenner.
Hey! That surfboard wheelie-dealie works great, Henry.
Maybe you want to start practicing, Corey.
Practicing for what, Master?
Oh, hi, Jeannie. The surfing championship on Saturday, that's what. I'm entered in the mixed doubles.
Mixed?
That's a boy and girl. One of each.
That means you will need a partner.
I wish she wouldn't do that.
Master?
Yay!
Was that not good?
Very good, Jeannie, but...
Then I will be your partner.
Guess again, Shorty. I'm the only partner he's got. Who's the chubby kid, Corey?
Chubby?
Uh-oh.
Is she a... She's a friend of Henry's. Right, Henry?
Huh? Oh, yeah, yeah.
We better go, Aggie.
Chubby. Excited? I just adore being your partner.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Whee! This is fun.
Cut that out.
Hey, what'd you do that for?
It wasn't me, Aggie. Honest.
No, then who was it?
Just nobody.
Nobody, huh?
Stop it, Jeannie.
What's the matter with you? My name's not Jeannie. Are you hurt, Master?
All right, Jeannie. What's the big idea?
I do not understand what you mean, Master. What big idea?
Oh, come on, Jeannie. You know what big idea.
Oh, you mean the accident. I was only trying to help him out.
Help him out? No. Wipe him out? Yes.
Hey, what are you doing now?
Nothing, Master. Merely cleaning you up.
Never mind cleaning me up. And what do you mean, trying to help?
I was afraid you were in danger.
Danger of what?
The way that female was clutching you, I did not think you could breathe.
Listen, Jeannie, Aggie and I are partners in next week's surfing competition.
Oh, I am sure we can find someone much better for you.
Like you, maybe?
What a wonderful idea, Master. Why did I not think of that?
Knock it off, Jeannie. I'm warning you. Any more stunts like this, and I'll put you back in your bottle and have you recycled.
You would not do that.
Just try me.
Corey! Get me out of here! Yikes!
Let's go, Aggie. Surf's up. Hey, Babu. What are you doing here?
I'm practicing. I'm trying to make this crab disappear.
Oh, you flunked disappearing one again?
Yeah, the way it's going, I'll never get to be a genie first class.
That's tough.
Okay, here we go. Yapple dapple. Vanish. All right. Well, back to the old Ouija board. Henry?
Down here!
Why did you leave? You might have missed my trick.
Never mind. Just get me out of here. Someone's coming.
Uh-oh. Better go. See you later.
Babu, you forgot your hat.
Nobody is perfect.
Who are you talking to, dum-dum? Hi, Smelly.
My name is S. Melvin. S. Melvin Farthinghill, you clod.
Sorry, Smelvin.
Say, isn't that Aggie out there with Corey?
Yeah, they work pretty well together, huh?
Are you kidding? She's doing all the work. That muscle-bound, knot-headed Corey has absolutely no class. If it weren't for Aggie... Yikes! It's a tidal wave! Run!
Now that's a wipeout!
That will teach him to call my master names. Poor master. He must be miserable having to spend so much time with that girl.
He sure doesn't look miserable.
Men.
No, Jeannie, don't!
It's Foam City!
Uh-oh, he's not gonna be happy about that.
Perhaps it will convince him he needs a new partner.
Boy, I'm sure off my form. You see how that wave wiped me out?
Well, maybe it wasn't exactly your fault.
What do you mean, wasn't my... Uh-oh, Jeannie. Where is she?
Oh, thank you, Master. I just love hot dogs.
Jeannie, when I get my hands on you...
Hands on who?
On my surfboard. I can't wait to get my hands on my surfboard.
Well, you better learn to keep your feet on it.
Oh, that was just an accident. We'll win this thing easy.
Providing you pass that math exam.
No problem. Come on, Aggie. Let's...
Wait a minute. What's this about a math exam?
Nothing, Aggie. Honest.
Look, if there's any chance of your blowing this deal, S. Melvin wants me to be his partner.
Hi, Jeannie. Oops!
Oops! Shh! Listen to this.
Even if he failed the exam, Aggie, he could take a makeup test on Saturday.
Which means he couldn't be here.
But I know I did great, so no problem. Come on, let's go.
You hear that? If Corey fails a test, she won't be his partner.
But he is sure he passed it.
Oh, yeah. But what if the paper got lost?
Babu, with that kind of thinking, you will be a genie first class in no time.
Hey, wait for me! Sorry. Uh-oh. Those must be the test papers, Jeannie.
And Corey's paper must be in that pile. Ouch!
What was that?
Never mind who. Just go back to sleep.
Who?
Master, I really do not believe that that girl is a good partner for you. Somehow I do not trust her.
Well, you're wrong. Aggie is a great partner, and she's completely loyal and trustworthy.
And here she comes now. Better split, Jeannie.
Hi, dum-dums.
Hi, Aggie. About Saturday.
There's been a change of plans for Saturday. S. Melvin and I are going to be partners.
Sorry, pal. The one you got it, you got it. And I got it.
Yeah, and that new monogram surfboard he gave her didn't hurt either.
Is that your idea of loyal and trustworthy, Master?
I guess you were right about her.
Well, there goes the old surfing championship.
No way!
Huh?
Jeannie can be my partner.
I can? You mean it? Oh, Master!
What's up, Jeannie?
I'm going to be my master's partner. That other girl, Aggie, she...
Hey, what's going on with Corey and Mr. Evans?
But I turned it in, Mr. Evans.
I'm sorry, Corey, but I can't find it. I'm afraid you'll have to take the makeup on Saturday.
Oh, you better get Corey's paper back or you'll both be out of the contest.
I forgot about that. I had better do it right now.
Yeah, I'll help you.
Me, I want it back again.
I got it!
Babu, do you not have some disappearing practice to do?
That's a good idea, Jeannie. I guess you can handle this by yourself.
I would like to try. There is the paper. I have missed it. Oh, my. Now where to? Danger. Wind tunnel. Keep out. Oh, I must get that paper.
Okay. The wind machine is ready. Let's try her out.
I got it. Oh!
Good enough. Shut her off.
Oops. The paper. Now I shall get it. Missed it again.
All right, little car, you're about to disappear. Yapple dapple, vanish! Hey, you got it?
It was not easy.
Neither is making things disappear. I do everything the Jeannie book says, but nothing works right. Look, yapple dapple, vanish!
Babu!
Hey! Corey's sidecar is gone.
And so is his mathematics paper.
Maybe the only reason you buy Kool-Aid is because your children ask for it. But if you think about it, there are better reasons. Kids aren't the only ones who like Kool-Aid. Parents do, teenagers, even grandparents. And you can quench everybody's thirst with Kool-Aid for about half the price of the leading brand of soda. The Kool-Aid is lighter. It also has vitamin C. You know, buying Kool-Aid's smarter than you think.
My baloney has a first name. It's O-S-C-A-R. My baloney has a second name. It's M-A-Y-E-R. Oh, I love to eat it every day. And if you ask me why, I'll say, 'cause Oscar Mayer has a way with B-O-L-O-G-N-A.
Oscar Mayer, the first name in Bologna.
How's that?
You get a big delight in every bite with wonderful Hostess cream-filled Twinkies. Delicious. delicious Hostess Twinkies pick you up, 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 and never let you down, because they taste so good. Luscious, creamy white filling inside, surrounded by soft, golden sponge cake. Great for snacks and lunchbox treats. You get a big delight in every bite. Hostess Cream-Filled Twinkies. Hostess fruit pies in cherry, apple, berry, and other favorite flavors with more fruit filling than crust, with a flaky soft crust that's sugar glazed. Snack time, anytime. You get a big delight in every bite. Hostess fruit pies.
Well, that's it for me. I'll be here taking a makeup test tomorrow.
There goes the surfing contest.
First Aggie defects, then someone swipes our sidecar, and now this. I sure have a real hot streak going.
Let's hope Jeannie's having better luck.
Babu, we must make his mathematics paper reappear.
I've been trying honest, but all the wrong stuff keeps showing up. Watch. Can you see what I mean?
Babu, you must remember that nothing really disappears. Jeannie power just removes things to other places. You have to keep track of them.
I hear you won't be in the surfing contest tomorrow, Corey dear.
I guess not. My math exam paper is missing, so...
He probably did it himself because he knew he'd lose out to us. No class.
Do you hear that, Babu?
Hey! Hey! The way they build those cheap cars, no class at all.
I wonder who swiped the sidecar.
If I knew, I'd...
Yikes!
May I ride home with you in your sidecar, Master?
You know we don't have a sidecar.
Merely details. Master, I must tell you something and promise you will not get mad.
Okay, I promise. What is it?
I was the one who took your mathematics paper.
Jeannie!
Is it not a nice day? Shall we go on a picnic?
You? Jeannie, did you find it?
I have gone back 1,000 years, but there is no sign of it.
Well, that does it.
Babu is still looking. I left him in 1776.
It's no use, Jeannie. We might as well give up.
But, Master...
In order to qualify, I'd have to be at the beach by 2:00. I can't be in 2 places at once.
What a wonderful idea, Master. Why did I not think of that?
Huh?
I think I can fix things.
Hold it. You've fixed enough things. Now just knock it off.
But, Master...
I mean it, Jeannie. I don't want to see you again until this thing is finished.
Yes, Master. Babu? Babu? The things we genies do for our masters. Delaware River. Uh-oh. Oh, that Babu. Babu? What are you doing here?
I'm looking.
There is no time to look. It's action time.
Prentice Jeannie, Babu ready for action, Chief.
Babu, listen. Corey must be in 2 places at once.
Hey, that's a good trick, even for a genie. I want to see him do it.
He cannot do it. That is why you must impersonate him.
You mean I should make believe I'm Corey?
That is it, exactly.
But I don't look like him.
Babu, if you ever expect to become a genie first class, you must be able to turn yourself into different things.
Well, I'll try. Yapple dapple. How was that?
Very good for a first attempt. But since we are in a hurry, I had better help you.
I knew I could do it.
Just one more thing. there.
But I don't know how to surf.
You will not have to. Just pretend you are Corey until he gets here.
Attention, all contestants, stand by. Championships start in 10 minutes.
Oh, dear. Corey cannot possibly make it.
Boy, you shouldn't ever touch that test paper, Jeannie.
That is it. I never should have touched it in the first place.
Huh?
I will just reverse time so that I never did take it. Time be now.
What's this? Why, it's Corey. The strangest thing, I just found your old exam paper.
You did? Oh, wow.
I guess you won't have to finish that makeup after all.
Wild.
Master.
Jeannie, you'll never guess what. Oh, so it was you again, huh?
I was only trying to help, Master.
We'll talk about that later. Right now, we need transportation to the beach.
Yes, Master.
Jeannie, we need wheels, not legs.
Oh, I am sorry.
Go, boy.
Don't worry, Master. I will have you there and...
Look out!
It is all right, Master. You are safe.
I never thought we'd... That does it. Put this thing down.
Now?
Right now.
Very well, Master.
Oh, no! Jeannie.
Master, if you will just close your eyes, I will get you there in my way.
Well, hurry it up.
Boy, Smelvin and Aggie are gonna be hard to beat.
You're next, Corey. Better get your board.
No way, Henry. I'm a genie, not a surfer. I'm not going out there.
Relax, Babu. I'll take over now.
Don't even bother trying, Meathead.
You'll never top us.
Never mind, partner. We'll show him.
By the beard of Haji, that we will.
And none of your genie tricks. We'll win this fair and square.
Hey, what for?
Go, man. Fantastic.
Boy, they're super.
Are they ever sensational?
And she's not even using her genie tricks.
She's not?
Of course not. That wouldn't be fair.
Hey, look at that.
What a cornball routine.
No class. They'll never win with that. Never.
All right, let's have a shot of the new champs. Hold it right there.
Corey, dear, I want to congratulate you on winning. Next year, when we're partners again... What's happening? Hey, watch it!
If there are going to be any partners next year, it is going to be us.
Look hungry. Come start your good breakfast with Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes cereal. The secret frosting makes it extra crunchy, extra delicious.
I know. Flakes of corn with just the right amount of frosting for kids and adults.
How did I teach you to say it?
It's great!
You may be Mr. Breakfast to the rest of the world, but you know what you are to me.
Your widow Tony.
I'm so proud of him. Sit up straight.
To a fruit and cereal lover, that last piece of fruit means the fun's all over. That's why at Post, we make our raisin bran with so many sweet, chewy raisins. You get them in your first spoonful, and your next spoonful, and your next. In fact, Post puts in so many raisins, you can get raisins in every spoonful. We don't want you to run out of fruit. That's why Post Raisin Bran's the fruit and cereal lover cereal.
Thank you.
is CBS.
Hey, what you think of Cocoa Pebbles, Fred?
They're chocolatey goodies.
What about a nutritious breakfast featuring Fruity Pebbles?
Beautiful, fruityful.
Yubba dubba fruity do.
Bonnie.
He got you, Fred.
And I've got swimming Freddy and Pebbles.
You put them together, wind him up, and let him go. He does the backstroke and the crawl. One in each specially marked box of Post Fruity or Cocoa Pebbles cereal.
Cities rising in the sky, freeway traffic jetting by. Futures here for us to see is 2200 AD.
Play-Doh man, a cat, a dog, a funny crocodile, a hobby horse, a yellow frog, a monkey with a smile, a cuckoo bird, an apple tree, a willy walrus, a moo-moo cow, a bumblebee, a Play-Doh-potamus, an elephant, a ball, a house, a polka dot giraffe, an aeroplane, a ship, a mouse, a face to make you laugh. Play-Doh, Play-Doh, you can make it with Play-Doh.
Every Play-Doh 4-pack has four blendable colors. Play-Doh, from the Play-Doh people.
For Alphabet. We're the Jackson 5. ABC is one of the hit records you get free on Alphabet. In Frosted Rice Crinkles, there are five different Jackson 5 records, one on each specially marked box. Of Post Alphabets in Frosted Rice Crinkles. Get them and bring home the Jackson 5!
Tex Comet should be picking us up any second now.
This gig is gonna be a blast. I've never been to Texas before.
Well, their luck had to run out sometime.
Very funny.
Hi!
Oh, what's the luggage for? Going on a trip?
No, this is Be Kind to Luggage Week, and we're taking it out to lunch.
A wealthy Texan hired us to entertain at a party he's giving at his ranch.
I'm gonna ride horses just like a real cowboy.
You can't ride horses. You're too young.
I'm older than you are.
But I'm a girl. And we age faster, don't we, Mom?
Yes, dear. Especially mothers.
Hey, here comes Tex.
You'd never guess he was from Texas.
Howdy, folks.
We're really looking forward to seeing Texas.
I wish we were going with you.
I'm just green with envy.
Why don't you kids join the posse and come along with us?
Can we? Oh, boy.
Oh, thank you, sir.
The name's Tex. T-E-double-X.
All right, children, get your luggage.
Don't fuss with it, ma'am. I'll handle it. All right, partners, let's hit the trail.
Hold it. Where's Orbit?
Come on, Orbit, get on the ball.
Wow, 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 wow.
Orbit, I didn't mean... No, come on.
If everybody's ready, let's ride! Giddy up, Bessie!
Yippee! Yeah!
Texas is west?
Oh, we ain't going to that dinky little state of Texas. We're heading for the island Texas with two X's. Yeah. Built it myself, and it's twice as big as that there other Texas.
No kidding. Sounds great.
Too bad we won't be able to see much of it in one day.
You're joshing. Ma'am, I didn't buy you for just one day. You lucky folks are going to spend the rest of your lives on my little old island.
Uh-oh.
Tex, you can't buy people. It's against the law.
Ma'am, in Texas, I make the law.
Oh, boy.
Hold on to your saddle horns. We're coming in for a landing. Whoa, Betty. Whoa. Welcome to the island of Texas, y'all. Hold on, folks. We're off to the ranch. Get up, you critters. Well, partners, what do y'all think of that little old ranch house?
You certainly have a magnificent home, Tex.
Oh, this ain't my home, ma'am. This is your house.
Our house? Wow.
You took the word right out of my mouth.
You're gonna spend lots of happy years here.
Tex, I know you mean well, but we're really very happy with the home we have.
Now, y'all scoot into the house and change into some Western duds.
There must be some way to get off this island.
Why don't we swim home?
10,000 miles?
Let's split up and see if we can find a way out.
Good idea. Danny, Beanie, and I will ride into town. The rest of you look around the ranch.
Don't get lost.
Salute. Only cowboys allowed.
Maybe somebody in there can tell us how to get off this island.
We can't go in there. We're not cowboys.
If we act like cowboys, they won't know the difference.
Someone in here must know a way to get us home.
I'll go talk to the bartender. Come on, Orbit.
Howdy, strangers.
In the range all day, and I got a hankering to wet my whistle.
Well, what's your pleasure, cowboy?
Give me a triple root beer float with a bent straw.
Bow wow, rough bow wow.
And my friend will have a bone on the rocks.
Coming up.
Here's looking at you, partner. Now you know why they call me the fastest straw in the West.
Partner, do you know how we can get off this island?
Don't bother me. My ice cream cones are melting.
Hey!
You calling us?
I know how you can get off this island.
You do?
Go see my friend Square Shooter Sam, the used rocket dealer. He'll take care of you.
Gee, thanks. Whoops. Sorry, partner.
We sure aren't having any luck. I wonder how the boys are doing in town.
Look what's coming.
Hey, look at them purdy gals.
Whoa!
Hi there.
Howdy, I'm me.
I'm Marnie.
And I'm Bo.
Well, where are you taking those cows?
We're taking them to our hideout. We're cattle rustlers.
You won't snitch on us, will you?
Who'd believe us? We're trying to get off the island. Can you take us with you?
Okay. Maybe our boss can help you get where you want to go.
I can hardly wait to meet him.
This is the hideout?
You ought to do something about that leaky plumbing. Wow. The rustling business must be pretty good.
Boss, we got company.
Howdy, y'all!
Don't you ever stay home?
Ma'am, ain't no way to get off this island. Listen, I say so.
We're right back where we started.
Yes, ma'am. And this is where you're gonna stay.
Square Shooter Sam, used rocket ships.
This is it.
Hi there. I'm Square Shooter Sam.
We're looking for a rocket ship that can get us off the island.
You're in luck, son. I've only got one left. Ain't she a beauty?
It looks a little beat up.
Yeah, it's got more patches than paint.
Oh, them ain't patches. Them's competition stripes. This little gym is practically new. It was owned by a little old lady who only used it to visit her grandson next door.
How much do you want for it?
Because I'm a square shooter, I'll only charge you $500.
We're not pigeons, we're partridges. We'll pay you $200. Here's the money. Take it or leave it.
Kid, you sure you don't own a used rocket lock?
I hope we can get this pile of junk off the ground.
Let's give it a try.
Hold on to your hats. We're blasting off.
It took off. Well, what do you know?
This sure isn't the smoothest ride I've ever had.
When we get home, we'll pick up our rocket and come back for Mom and the kids.
The jumping Jupiter!
Yeah.
We're going down!
Boy, we sure got home fast!
We made it! We got out of Texas!
That was long!
I'll bet Sam didn't tell you that rocket's got a homing device that always brings it right to me.
What do you expect, Mom? It's no fun singing anymore.
Hey, listen. I just got an idea how we can get out of here.
Without hearing it, I bet I've got a better one.
What's that?
You're the genius in the family. Why don't you just reprogram that rocket you bought so it'll fly out of here?
She's right. I am a genius.
And modest, too.
But Tex has the rocket locked up in a hangar.
So I'll have to dream up a clever plan to get in there.
Hiya, partner.
Howdy, young'uns.
Could we take your picture for our scrapbook?
Sure thing. Where's your camera?
Right here.
Hopping horn toads. What kind of dog is that?
He's a camera hound. This picture didn't come out too good. Let's go look for a place where the light's better.
We gotta work fast.
You girls let us know when you see that cowboy coming back. Hurry it up. Chris and Tracy can't stall those cowboys forever.
Somebody's coming. Look!
Marion, we've got to keep our cool. Don't go bananas.
Howdy, gals. What are you doing here?
Oh, we were just keeping an eye on the hangar till you got back.
My name's Jetstream. What's yours?
Marion Moonglow.
Hey, where are you going, gal?
Marion, not in the hangar.
I just connected the homing device. Now all we've got to do is...
Marion, come back!
Oh, no!
That dumb Marion. She's gonna give us away.
I better go for... for help.
That runaway filly ain't gonna get away from me. I got you, little gal.
Let's get out of here. I think we're scaring the rocket.
Hey, Snoopy, wake up. It's time to brush our teeth.
Good grief, it's time to brush your teeth with your Snoopy toothbrush. Brushing right makes you smile bright with your Snoopy toothbrush.
Snoopy makes you want to brush your teeth.
Good grief, it's fun to brush your teeth.
It's fun to brush your teeth with Snoopy.
Happiness is a battery-operated Snoopy toothbrush by Kenner.
Look at those colors. It's Mattel's Hot Wheels flying colors, racy colors, with details so bold and colors so bright on 24 flying colors cars. This is the Hot Wheels flying colors double dare set with a fair start button and a finish gate where you finish with flying colors. Hot Wheels Flying Colors Double Dare comes with two cars, 24 Flying Colors cars in all, each sold separately from Mattel.
The meat round spaghetti, you can eat with a spoon. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. The meat, little meatball that'll fit on your spoon. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
It's the greatest invention since the napkin.
Franco-American, uh-oh, SpaghettiOs.
Don't forget the big rodeo today, folks. Front busting, wild cow milking, bulldogging, calf roping, and the lucky winner gets $1 million. But the cowboy who finishes in last place gets booted out of Texas forever.
Did you hear that? The loser has to leave the island.
Hey, this could be our big chance. One of you fellas has to enter that rodeo. You're a cinch to win last prize.
I know the perfect guy.
Don't look at me. You're not conning me into breaking my neck.
But Keith, you're the bravest one in the whole family.
You're just warming your jets. I'm used to your con job, and I'm not falling for it. No way! What you're doing?
Don't worry. I fixed your horse so you can't win.
Keith Partridge just set a new record for bulldogging. 1 second flat.
Oh, that's awful.
You mean he can do better than that? Now, Jetstream, the champion cowboy of Texas, is going to show you some real calf roping. Uh-oh, his electro lariat broke. That'll cost him a lot of points.
Uh-oh, we're in big trouble. If you win this event, you'll be in first place.
Not a chance. I'm going to aim my lariat so far away from that calf, it'll never touch him.
Come on, Keith. Do your worst.
That ought to cinch last place.
Partridge rope four calves at once. That boy is unbelievable. That ride put Jetstream back in the lead, folks. Keith Partridge has to score 20 points in his final ride to beat him.
I'm getting this bull so revved up, he'll buck Keith off and nothing flat.
Wow.
Give me a hand here, Orbit. Orbit, you shorted it out. Hey, home is magnetized, like a great big magnet.
I hope you did a good job on that bull. I don't want to blow the last prize.
You're a cinch to lose. But just to make sure, put this coil spring in their back pocket.
Good idea. That'll spring me off the bull fast. I did it! I lost!
Hey! It's that coil spring in his pocket. The magnet is pulling him back on the bull.
This is where I get off. Bye!
Stupid bull. I'll never eat steak again.
Come on! Let's try it again!
Oh! The winner and new champion of our island is the Partridge! All right, everybody! Quiet down! It's time for the big event of the evening!
Remember, kids, this is our last chance to get off the island.
And here they are, folks. Our own Partridge Family. Yay! 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 Yay!
Yay! Yay! Yay! Yay! Oh, sleep or
what kind of singing is that?
Something wrong, Tex?
Wrong? We got hog callers who sound better than that.
But that's our best number.
Then you got no business in show business. I know it's going to break your hearts, but I'm sending you home.
Oh, I think I'm going to cry.
Crying won't do no good. I'm putting you on the next rocket out of here. And there ain't no way to change my mind.
Let's hear it the way that song should be done.
Temperature is on the rise. The doctor says it's in my eyes. It's contagious. Stay away from you.
What a shot! The Watsons have just about clinched the $1 million rebound championship. Bob, give us the highlights up to this point.
Well, Jim, the Kleppels took an early lead in this two-cushion rebound game, but after the fourth shot, were a solid 60 points ahead. Then Dick Watson came through with a beauty to even the score. In the sixth, with tension mounting, Jerry Kleppel flubbed a big one, leaving it wide open for the spectacular shot that just about wrapped up the game for the Watsons.
Thank you, Bob. Now back to live action. The Kleppels are down to their last shot, worth $1 million. And, what a shot it'll have to be.
He's taking his time. He aims. It's off the right bank. Perfect off the left wall. Through the two blues. He's made it.
And we were only kidding about the $1 million.
Rebound. A competitive game for two or four players from Ideal.
CBS.
This fall, see the best. CBS.
Oh.
Your star is bright every single night.
Deep in the heart of the Amazon, the Butler family was exploring an uncharted river canyon. Suddenly, caught up in a violent whirlpool, they were propelled through an underground cavern and flung into a hostile world of giant prehistoric creatures. A world that time forgot. Now befriended by a family of cave dwellers, each day is an adventure in survival for the Butlers in the Valley of the Dinosaurs.
Hank Aaron. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Home Run Baseball by Coleco. It's a whole new ball game.
It's Big Jim's rescue rig, and you can buy Big Jim with his talking field radio. Big Jim was on patrol when the rock slide shook, so he tells his men,
I'm going in for a look.
Then the mountain trembled suddenly, and Big Jim gets trapped by a big old tree.
We need the rescue boom.
The crew calls out to Jim, and working very eagerly, they haul him safely in. Big Jim rescue rig comes with its own talking unit. Big Jim, a talking field radio sold separately from Mattel.
CBS.
A winding road, that's the place with its Hot Wheels flying colors. Downhill race. A mountain steep, exciting run, that race called Hot Wheels Cutoff Canyon. Now different views of the race you won. Your car swerved at the start of the run. Your buddy was ahead, but not for long. Past Cutoff Canyon, you were going strong. Running Cutoff Canyon, you never know if you got them till the bottom. Hot Wheels Cutoff Canyon comes with everything you see. You put it together from Mattel.
Helicopter, Lego, tow truck, come in, tow truck.
Emergency on Sunnydale Bridge.
Past Lego Village, up a level. Get the bus back on the bridge.
We ought to make a safety rail.
Here's some more Lego building bricks.
With Lego, you can build buses and houses and bridges and helicopters, even the new safety rail on the Sunnydale Bridge.
Helicopter to tow truck, telephone pole, down on Main Street.
Lego Building Set 145 has wheels, windows, movable shutters and doors, and hundreds of bricks for building. There's no end to Lego.
Chosen from among all others by the immortal elders Solomon, Hercules, Atlas, Zeus, Achilles, Mercury, Billy Batson and his mentor travel the highways and byways of the land on a never-ending mission to right wrongs, to develop understanding, and to seek justice for all. In time of dire need, young Billy has been granted the power by the immortals to summon awesome forces at the utterance of a single word.
Shazam!
Word which transforms him in a flash into the mightiest of mortal beings, Captain Marvel.
You know
what kids love? Monsters. I'm Gorgonzola, one of the new monster vitamins. We come in a haunted house, seven of us.
I'm Screaming Mimi.
I'm Squeaky.
I'm the Blob.
We're delicious.
Mom, we think children should get vitamins by eating right. But when they don't, monsters can help. New monster vitamins and monster vitamins with iron. Look for the haunted house in your favorite store.
Bonneville Blasters are ready to race.
Blasters, blasters are gonna explode. With the blast of power, gonna eat up the road.
Time to refuel, fill them with water, pump them with power.
Blasters, blasters are gonna explode. With the blast of power, gonna eat up the road.
Bonneville Blasters, complete with funnel and power launcher. New from Hasbro.
Cereal because it tastes good and I ought to know I'm the boss.
Oh, so it has a lot of vitamins. Ooh.
Indubitably, this is a very crunchy cereal. Very worthy. Super eminent.
What is he saying?
I don't know.
And I like Freaky Cereal because it's sugary and sweet, like me.
You too can have crunchy, sugary, Freaky Cereal every morning.
Lovely long hair, lovely blonde swirl. You can make Barbie do a lovely twirl. You free moving Barbie, Ken and PJ. Swing and dance when you play. Set them up for sports and tennis. Barbie swinging. Golf PJ's beginning their free moving friends.
New free moving Ken is a tennis star too. Free moving Barbie, Ken and PJ dolls are each sold separately with their own accessories. New from Mattel.
Machine with Roger Allen Ripley, Avery Driver as Mr. Evil. Today's special guest star, Ted Knight, and Don in the Harlem Globetrotters.
I met a lot of them, man. You gotta know. Curly is also on the show. To show you how. And I'm John.
I'm Theodore.
And I'm Nate.
And right now, Rodney Allen Rippy, take a bow. Get the show on the road. Let's start it all off with the Globetrotter Code. Give me an O!
O is for obedience.
Give us an S!
S is for sincerity.
Give us an E! Give us an R.
R for respect.
Repeat that R.
R for repeat that R.
Give us a T.
T. T is for trust.
Give us an H.
H is for honesty.
Give us a B.
B. J, B is for brotherhood.
Put them all together and it spells... Supposed to spell brother for brotherhood. You know how people respect each other regardless of race, religion, or whether they speak a different language? The way people ought to get along together. All of that is brotherhood, not hebrots. Hey, hold it, cool it, fellas. This is a show about brotherhood.
Right, brother.
Right on.
Come to the honeycomb hideout.
I'm Big Betty and I'm tired of small cereals, so give me one with a big bite.
Honeycomb's big and it's got a big bite.
Right. Honeycomb's part of a balanced breakfast and it gives you a big bite.
A wacky roller printer inside. Put it together. Ink it. Roll it.
Footprint.
Look at the footprint.
Wow.
Far out. Three wacky roller printers. One in each specially marked box of those honeycomb cereal.
My tummy wants something yummy. Better give it Super Sugar Crisp.
Sugar Bear.
Yeah, Sugar Fox?
I got Super Sugar Crisp and you can't have any.
Is it yummy?
Right.
Yummy for your tummy?
Right.
Well, I got something and you can't have any.
Well, what do you got?
I got the Super Sugar Crisp. My tummy needed something yummy. A good breakfast featuring Post Super Sugar Crisp cereal. Just gave my tummy something yummy. Yummy Super Sugar Crisp.
And now, back to the Harlem Globetrotters popcorn machine.
A friend to you.
I'm waiting here for my old friend Frankie. He's a little different from most folks, but I sure do like him. Hey, here he comes now. Hi, Frankie.
Oh, how's it going, old buddy?
Ow.
Gee, it sure is good to see you.
Ow.
Boy, you don't know your own strength. Well, I have to be going now. Give my best to the mad doctor.
So long, Frankie.
He's a good pal. But I have to admit, Frankie sure is hard to like.
Ow. I'm Marcus Haynes. I love to dribble, but I don't like fighting and I hate to quip. We all should try to get along, even if you think somebody's wrong.
I'm right.
No, I'm right.
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 Wait.
Hold this, fellas. Did you ever stop to think that the both of you could be right?
Of course you are.
I'm Orville right.
And I'm Wilbur right.
You invented the airplane?
Right.
Sometimes everybody can be right.
Biggest. But worst thing of all, at least in my book, is to make fun of how people look.
Well, look at you. Why, you're the littlest squirt I ever saw. Just look at the size of you. You're just a pint-sized, itsy-bitsy, eeny-teeny thing. Well, I've seen buttons bigger than you. Man, I thought shrimp ruled until I saw that itty bitsy thing. Yes, sir. Is there something I can do for you? Thank you, sir.
So remember, folks, we always should keep believing in brotherhood.
This is Ted Knight for a great big globe of sports. Today our cameras are covering the Globetrotters Open Golf Tournament at Dribble Beach.
Right now, Bobby Joe Mason is leading on the 18th tee with three under par. His faithful caddy tees up for Bobby Joe. A beautiful drive straight down the middle. Uh-oh, it's hooking into a sand trap. Or is it a beach? No, it's a sand trap. Some dummy mistook for a beach.
I'm sorry, sir, you'll have to leave. We'll be back later with more exciting action from Dribble Beach.
Welcome to our beneficial basketball court clinic. Each week, for 1 minute, we'll be giving helpful hints to budding basketballers so that they can beat and bedazzle their buddies on the opposing team. In each sensational 60-second sequence, I'll give you the real lowdown on how to be better at basketball, whether you be in Buffalo, Birmingham, or Boston. You'll be unbeatable because of my basics, which will bestow bravado to those with more brains than brawn.
Man, you better hurry up. Your minute's almost gone.
That's impossible. I just started.
Your minute's gone.
But I haven't given any helpful hints yet.
Sure you have.
What was that?
You're never gonna beat the clock if all you do is talk, talk, talk.
I didn't know that.
Uncle Metalock, what bedtime story are you going to tell me this time?
Well, it's by the Brothers Grimm, and the story is called The Ugly Duckling.
Two grim brothers telling me about an ugly duck? I'm going to have nightmares.
No, of course you have Uncle Metalock here. Now just settle down and listen. Once upon a time, in a forest by a lake, some ducklings had just hatched out of their eggs. But there were one big egg that didn't seem as if it was going to hatch at all.
Hey, hold it down, fellas. I'm trying to pick up on what's going on in this egg, and I can't do that with you going quack, 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 quack.
We're supposed to say quack. We're ducks.
Yeah, just like geese say honk.
Wrong, car say honk.
Yeah, so do geese.
See, geese is a Harlem Globetrotter. Why would he say honk?
I mean the geese that are birds.
Birds say
tweet, tweet. We're birds and we say quack, quack.
And I'm dubious.
No, you're not. You're a duck.
Hold it, fellas. This egg is finally hatching.
Are you my brothers?
I hope not. You're the funniest looking duck I've ever seen.
Let's face it, you are an ugly duckling.
Oh, thanks a lot. But even hatch here to be insulted.
Maybe you're not even a duck. Can you say, quack, quack?
Why would I want to say a dumb thing like that?
Maybe he's a goose. Stay honk.
Silly cars say honk.
See, I told you. I know how we can find out what he is. Let's take him to the doctor.
Doctor? I want to go see some quack.
Ah, he is a duck. He said it. You heard him.
I don't care what he is. I don't want anything to do with him.
Right. Let's go, fellas. And don't you follow us. We don't want any silly-looking bird like you hanging around.
And even if you can't sit home, on a scale of good-looking, you'll get a goose egg.
Quack, 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 quack.
Gee, I guess I don't belong anywhere. Just an ugly bird, unwanted, unloved, because of the way I look. I wish I'd never been hatched.
Don't be sad. I'll be your friend.
You will? Who are you?
I'm a swan.
Swans are the most beautiful birds in the world. Why would you want to be my friend?
Why not? You're a swan, too.
Me? A swan?
Sure. Swans are too beautiful to lie.
Oh, wait till those silly ducks find out that I'm really a swan. They'll be sorry for the way they treated me.
Come, let's join the others, where you'll live happily ever after.
Wonderful. Let's go.
But first, there's one thing I think you ought to know.
What's that?
You are the ugliest looking swan I've ever seen.
We'll return to the popcorn machine after these messages.
Carmel. Chewy, chewy Carmel. Extra rich in Carmel. Nestle's $100,000 bar.
Chewy, chewy caramel and lots of toasted crunchies. Double dunked in more Nestle's rich chocolate than ever. If you really like caramel,
this is your caramel bar. Nestle's $100,000 bar.
Oh. Freakies,
we are the freakies,
and this is the freakies
tree.
We never miss
a meal,
cause we love it here in
the
hills. This is the big boss, we call the boss boss.
Make sure you spell it right. Snorkeled off, they call me so handsome and pretty.
He's little
and he's got a weird nose.
Do I really have to sing?
My name is Grumble.
I am Tumumble.
You're standing on my foot.
Grumble, this is me.
Small, this is my game. I know more than you do.
Yes, you.
And don't forget me. I'm goody goody. I always do what's right. For instance, I eat freaky cereal because it's got a lot of vitamins and it's good for me.
You too can have crunchy, freaky cereal as part of your good breakfast. And there's a free freaky magnet in specially marked boxes.
Okay, here comes the big finish.
We are the free.
And now, back to the popcorn machine.
Now back to the Globetrotter Open Golf Classic at Pebble Beach.
Bobby Joe is still leading, but he's got a difficult shot here from the sand trap. His caddy is offering various clubs that might be used, but Bobby Joe is refusing all advice. What Bobby Joe has to try to do is get that ball out of the trap so that it dribbles to the edge of the green. And that's exactly what he's doing. What a great shot.
The Adventures of Super Trotter. By day, our superhero is disguised as a mild-mannered basketball. But whenever freedom, truth, and nice stuff is threatened, he becomes Super Trotter. Today, Dr. I. M. Wacky, world's foremost mad scientist, has hatched a horrible plan.
I hate a lot of things, but what I hate most is mustaches. People who wear mustaches are different from people who don't wear mustaches. And I don't have a mustache.
I've heard of prejudice and bigotry, but this is ridiculous.
So I have perfected this dangerous, dandy, double-track mustache ray to obliterate all people with hair on their upper lip.
What does obliterate mean?
It means that unless you get a fast shave, you're gonna be a pair of empty basketball shoes.
I'm Mr. Evil, but even I don't go along with this idea.
This is a job for Super Trotter.
Why should I get involved? I haven't got any hair at all.
You better, or I don't believe I ever speak to you again.
Just kidding. I wouldn't let you down.
And so, Super Trotter is on the way. Faster than a speeding jet. Speedier than a fast anything. Ready to avenge the evildoer who would threaten mustache mankind.
Mustache is ready. Now to count down. 10, 9, 8. What comes after 8?
Thanks, kids.
199, 98.
Hooray, Super Trotter! Hooray! And so, Super Trotter is on the way.
57. 56. 55. Come visit Super Trotter.
Just in a nick of time.
Big deal, I had 54 to go.
Now to destroy your dangerous dandy double track mustache ray.
Oh!
Well, I'll just take it with me. People with mustaches are safe to live in freedom and equality.
Oh, rats! It takes me a long time to think up these rotten schemes.
By the way, Dr. Wacky, why did you want to do away with people who wear mustaches?
Because my wife won't let me grow one.
She says it'll tickle her.
That makes sense. But now I want you to work on something to aid humanity.
Like what?
Like a way to grow hair.
Week, when we'll hear Super Trotter say,
that mad doctor isn't a bad fellow after all.
The Harlem Globetrotters are a shining example of people getting along together, especially considering how close they have to be when they travel on the road.
We need a good night's sleep so we'll be nice and fresh for the big game tomorrow. Good night, Nate.
Good night, Marcus.
Good night, Baba Joe.
Good night, Cole. Good night, Geese.
Good night, Don.
Good night, Theodore.
Good night, Matthew Waters.
Good night, Dee.
Good night, John.
Good night, Geese.
Good night, Joe.
Night, Papa Joe.
Hold it, hold it, hold it. That's enough good nights for the night. Let's go to sleep.
I can't sleep with that sign flashing on and off outside our window.
Well, we haven't got a window shade, so just go to sleep.
But I can't sleep. I wish I had a pair of sunglasses.
What does the sign say?
By Acme sunglasses.
Just go to sleep, will you? There's no way you're gonna get any sunglasses at this time of night.
Find your Acme sunglasses here. Get your Acme sunglasses. Here they are. Get your sunglasses. Get your Acme sunglasses. We got a little more of your sunglasses.
Take a pair, yeah.
Okay, here you go.
How much are they?
$20.
$20 for a pair of sunglasses?
Where else are you gonna get sunglasses this time of night?
Anything to get some sleep.
Thank you very much, sir. Here's your sunglasses. Thank you. Yeah. That flashing sign works every time.
Pass them on.
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 Hey, I don't need any sunglasses. These are for Curly.
But it was great fashion, fellas.
Pass them back.
Here, Curly.
Thanks, Bobby Joe.
Is that better?
It sure is. I can't see the flashing light at all now. All I can see is darkness.
Good. Now let's get some sleep.
I still can't sleep. What's the matter now, Curly?
I'm afraid of the dark.
This is going far enough. If anybody's still awake at the count of three, they don't get to play in the game tomorrow. One, two, three. Can't sleep. Sure wish I had a set of earplugs.
Earplugs here. Get your act the earplugs here. Yes, sir.
Now it's time for. Darn. I forgot what it's time for. But it's time for it anyway.
Little beach again as Bobby Joe Mason approaches his ball for a very delicate putt. He's on the edge of the green. Just a few feet from the cup. He's sizing up his putt. His caddy's anticipating a perfect putt. Bobby Joe's ready now. As I said, it's a very delicate putt that's needed here. And Bobby Joe Mason wins the tournament!
The open third of the popcorn machine after these messages.
Start your complete breakfast with Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes. They're great!
Why are they great?
Where have you been hiding, little lady? Everyone knows they're great.
But why?
That special frosting keeps them crisp in milk.
That is great.
And it even has 8 vitamins and iron. How does it taste, in your own words?
It's great!
Those are my words.
Sit down to breakfast with Tony, and you'll discover why it's
great!
Who are you?
Archaeologists. We theorize an ancient cookie factory once stood on the site of this tree.
I've hit cookies!
Ah! See?
You've hit our hollow tree. Those are Keebler fudge-covered cookies. Fudge stripes, fudge sticks, and deluxe grahams. Crisp cookies inside, rich fudge outside. I've hit elves! The cookies are baked by elves.
You'll never prove that theory.
Keebler fudge-covered cookies. Uncommonly good.
And now, back to the Harlem Globetrotters popcorn machine.
We have to go now, so until next week, give us an S!
S is for sportsmanship.
Give us an O!
O is for obedience.
Give us an L!
L is for loyalty.
Give us an O!
O is for opportunity.
Give us an N!
For niceness.
Give us a G.
G is for goodness.
For me, it's G for guilty. I'm guilty of everything.
Put them all together and it says, so long.
Comedy's favorite family, the Hudson Brothers, coming your way next, so stay tuned for the Razzle Dazzle Comedy Show.
Grab your alphabet and come with me. We're eating through the alphabet. A to Z.
With new Quick Curl Barbie Beauty Center, you do quick, curl, hairdo. Any styles you choose, no wetting, no setting. With Quick Curl Hair, you swirl it. You curl it. Makeup, too. Lashes, blusher, shadow, lipstick. You can do it.
That was fast.
Quick Curl Barbie Beauty Center has quick, curl hair. Quick Curl Barbie Beauty Center comes with hairstyling equipment and makeup. New from Mattel.
This is CBS.
It's the Hudson Brothers Razzle Dazzle Show. Starring Bill, Mark, and Brett, the Hudson Brothers. With Ken Ziegler, Billy Van, and Peter Cullen, Murray Langston and Freeman King, Avril Chow, the Bear, and Rod Hull and his extraordinary Australian emu. And sets, lights, and all sorts of fun things. On the Hudson Brothers Razzle Dazzle Show.
Razzle Dazzle.
Set yourself down.
Razzle Dazzle.
It's time to turn it on.
Razzle Dazzle.
Get up on your feet and Razzle Dazzle.
Voila, there they are. Hudson Brothers will be back in a little bit. Amazing how I can speak and not move my lips.
Big wheels are a-rolling. Listen to them turn. The big wheel sound of power with speed enough to burn. Winning. Spinning. Braking. The big wheel by Marks. With adjustable seat, handy saddlebag, and a quick stop racing brake. Braking. Winning. Spinning. It's the big wheel with saddlebag and racing brake. Big Wheel by Marks. If we make it, it can take it.
It's the Weeble Marina.
What do you love about a Weeble? Weebles wobble, but they don't fall down.
I'm going fishing. All Weebles on deck. We're going out to sea.
I like to fish.
What do you love about a Weeble? Weebles wobble, they don't fall down.
I love you, Weeble.
The Weeble Marina, complete with SS Little Putt and four Weebles, new from Romper Room.
U is for the underful fresh flavor. N is for the nutty things it do. C is for the cola, it's even prettier than. is for the one that satisfies you. L is for the light that you've been seeing. A is for the anything it goes with. And when you put it all together, it's Uncola. And that's 7-Up, everybody knows.
I can be any kid on the block. Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
They're slugging it out. A left to the jaw, and...
Oh, my block is knocked off.
But you can press it right back on. It's Rock'em Sock'em Robots. Press this lever. He throws a right, the other a left. Knock his block off. You're the winner.
Wait till next time.
You can rock'em sock'em with the Rock'em Sock'em Robots by Marks.
Hey, we're back again.
Oh, no.
It's Fabulous Freddy, Network Vice President in charge of kids programming.
Boys, I hate to start the show off with something serious, but I must. Please present paddleball paddles. Now, play paddleball. Mark.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Go, Marky!
Nice technique, Mark. Brett.
Now?
Yep, right now. Can't you be serious? I'm going out of my office. I'll shut the door and then try throwing my voice without moving my lips again.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
B.
Be who?
Between the three of us, we better do a song.
Hold it.
What's wrong, Bill?
Oh, Mark, I wish I'd put on my aftershave lotion. This isn't my aftershave lotion. Thanks. I needed that.
let's finish our song.
What do you get when you cross an angry, vicious gorilla with a laughing hyena?
I don't know. What do you get?
You get a gorilla who is still angry and vicious, but he smiles a lot.
That's really weird, Brett. And not funny.
You think that's weird? Wait till you see Rod Hull and his emu.
Coach, you're wondering why we're dressed like this. Yeah, never mind. You see, we're dressed like this because we're going to give you a show, just like a man called Houdini gave a show. Do you know who Houdini was? Well, he was a famous escapologist. Not only that, he could escape from things as well. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to show you exactly what he used to do, because I will bind myself and Emu in these heavy chains, and I'll just show you what I mean. It's a very heavy chain. I'll put round Emu's neck like that. There. Show everybody the heavy chain on your neck, Emu. There. Round there, and we put chains around ourselves. You can help me. Thank you very much, Emu. Yes. As you can see, it'd be quite impossible to get out of all these chains, but we will do it. The more the merrier, eh? Because we can escape, can't we? Not only will we escape from these chains, but we will also do it whilst being tied up in a sack. Yes. Put the sack over our heads, and before you know where you are, we will count up to three and escape. Before you know where you are, we will count up three and escape. Just a minute. Now, suppose you're down. Now, here we go. Right.
I can chop down a tree in a minute to be made into a table or a spinet, and it won't take me long, 'cause I do nothing wrong. Did he know that his pals were still in it?
When the Hudson brothers will be back in a second or two. I think I'll put this on my cardboard.
Red light, yellow, ready for SSP action. Green, go! It's the Golden Railbird against the clock.
6 seconds flat!
Kenner's exciting SSP time trial set gives the green light to big drag strip action. Challenge the other guy's SSPs.
Go! Here it comes!
Race against time and take the checkered flag. It stopped the clock!
Kenner's SSP time trial set with one SSP Golden Railbird by Kenner.
I am Tweaklord! I do everything fast!
Marathon John, you can't eat a marathon candy bar fast, Quick Claude. It lasts a good long time.
I show you milk chocolate, delicious caramel, and chewy.
Told you. Nobody eats a marathon bar quick, Claude.
Marathon lasts a good long time.
Some people have a deep, abiding respect for the natural beauty that was once this country. And some people don't. People start pollution. People can stop it. Write for Pollution Booklet, Box 1771, Radio City Station, New York.
See stars shine on CBS Saturday. See Pebbles, Bugs Bunny and Roadrunner, Scooby-Doo, Shazam and Isis, Space Nuts, Ghostbusters, Valley of the Dinosaurs, Bad Albert, the Children's Film Festival.
Well, we are back again to the Razzle Dazzle Wrap-Up.
Dazzle wrap up of everything, including the kitchen sink. The razzle dazzle wrap up of everything is lots more fun than you think.
A bit of this, a piece of that, an old melody.
It must be something fresh we call a potpourri.
What's a potpourri?
Why don't you wait and see?
This is the razzle dazzle wrap up of everything,
including some jokes and maybe some laughs.
A couple of cows,
a couple of calves. A garden hose, a family car, a skating rink, including the kitchen sink. Oh yeah, the razzle dazzle wrap up of everything, including the kitchen sink.
Wait a minute. What do you mean, wake up? Is it spring already?
No, no. I need your help. Hmm? My uncle left me his farm,
yeah?
But the will had one strange clause.
Well, I got that beat, lady. I got two strange claws.
He didn't tell me where his farm was. But I want you to help me find it.
Lady, that is the weirdest thing I ever heard. Listen, I'm a big-time detective, and I have no time to go looking for farms.
Yes, but this is a berry farm.
That I have time for. All right, lady, I'll just go and get my hat. I got my suit dress. I got my best dress. All I need now is to open the door. I'll be right with you, lady. Be right back. Excuse me. Rub-a-tick-tick. Excuse me. My foot keeps getting in the way. Okay, here I come. I think I may have locked myself in here. No problem. I'll just pound gently on the door and maybe it'll open. Just come on, take it. Hi there. Well, lady, let's go and find your farm.
Sure.
But whatever you do, remember one thing. Don't be conspicuous or attract attention, okay? Just be like me. Okay, here we go. Follow me, my dear. Thank you. Well, if I can't find the farm, I can always go surfing.
And now, here's the three galoshes.
Hi there. It's a song we wrote for our pet elephant.
Along. He's so much smarter than our old dog Rover, but we can't find our house since he's learned to roll over.
Did you fight a dragon today?
No. I'm tired of dragging around this suit of armor.
Uh-oh. You know what that means.
It's either King Arthur or the drawbridge has fallen on Sir Humphrey again.
Nights. I have important news.
What is it, sire?
I think I hurt myself just then. You men are out of shape. Now, in order to get you back into shape, I have invented a brand new game. It's called the High Hurdle. Follow me, men. It's quite simple. Keep your eyes on me. Watch. Do this. Do it for your king. Do it for your country.
Do it for me. Lady Patricia.
All right, men, jump! That was close, men.
Of everything,
including a sketch, a giggle, a grin, a handful of rice,
some gold and some tin, a bale of hay, a volleyball, and mother's ring, and even the kitchen sink. That's right, including the kitchen sink.
The Dazzle brothers will be back a little bit.
Parker Brothers' new Gnip-Gnop is very easy to play. You simply try to gnip your three balls through the hoops into the other side. And the other guy tries to gnop his three balls into your side. But while you're gnipping, he's gnopping. You're trying to out-gnip him while he's trying to out-gnop you. So gnip down to your store and grab the new game from Parker Brothers before they're all gnopped. From Parker Brothers, Gnip-Gnop.
Let's play fireman with Play-Doh Pumper Number 9.
Put in the Play-Doh, there it goes. Now pump out the Play-Doh hose.
Make the fireman's hats and the fire plug. Now hook up the hose.
Up the ladder, there he goes. Now pump out the Play-Doh hose. Playing fireman's lots of fun. You can make with Play-Doh.
Play-Doh Pumper Number 9. New from Kenner.
I'm Woodsy Owl. Please give a hoot about campgrounds. Because if you don't give a hoot,
who will?
Going up?
Here's Barbie's townhouse, three stories tall. Six rooms and a see-through elevator you make go up and down. Put it together and pretend Barbie's sweet 16 doll gets dressed in the bedroom. Pops down to the kitchen to check on dinner. Then waits for her guests on the patio. So many ways to play.
This elevator sure comes in handy.
Barbie's townhouse. Six rooms and the furniture you see here. Barbie's Sweet 16 sold separately. From Mattel.
Now back to Razzle Dazzle. Those Hudson brothers really crack me up. Ready?
Boys, during your show, I got a call from Mr. Big at the network.
Wow, I guess he called about the show, huh?
Probably wants to give us bigger dressing rooms.
Does Mr. Big want to make us superstars?
No. Mr. Big wanted to borrow my roller skates. Care for a mushy ice cream bar?
No, thanks. We're trying to cut down.
What is the time going? You're having so much fun.
We better say goodbye.
Not so fast.
Yeah, I just have enough time to read them all in my new book.
Yeah, we got an hour or two.
It was a dark, cold, and dreary afternoon when a big banana...
The part of Fabulous Freddy was played by Scott Fisher. Mm. This is Peter Cullen speaking. This program was recorded.
This is CBS.
Man, you never would believe where those Zesta saltines come from. They're baked by little elves in a hollow tree. And what do you think makes those crackers so uncommon? They're baked in magic ovens and there's no factory. Hey!
That's gotta be a factory. I don't believe in elves. But for a tiny little factory person, you bake uncommonly good saltines.
Zesta saltines. From Keebler.
Glass potato chip. That's the best.
I like them as a snack.
Just put a bag down in front of me and I'll finish them off one by one.
They're just always fresh and crisp.
And it is terrific!
That's why they're number one.
The year.
Lego tow truck. Come in, tow truck. Emergency on Sunnydale Bridge. Past Lego Village. Upper level. Get the bus back on the bridge.
We ought to make a safety rail.
Here's some more Lego building bricks.
With Lego, you can build buses and houses and bridges and helicopters. Even the new safety rail on the Sunnydale Bridge.
Helicopters, the tow truck, telephone pole down on Main Street.
Lego Building Set 145 has wheels, windows, movable shutters and doors, and hundreds of bricks for building. There's no end to Lego.
This is how Lego grows. Like a song, Lego building bricks start out simple. First, it's new Lego preschool for little hands. Then Lego building sets and models for older children. With more Lego wheels to snap on, moving shutters and doors, Lego grows from child to child. Hour after hour, day after day, year after year, Lego changes. Start with one little piece and see how it grows. There's no end to Lego.
This is CBS.
When the pros race, skill counts. They make one wrong move, they blow the race. Hot Wheels Thundershift 500 puts racing action in your hands. Power them up with a shift. Through the tunnel and shift again. That's Thundershift 500 action. And the faster you shift, the faster your speed in the turns. He blew the shift, and you're the Thundershift 500 champ. Hot Wheels Thundershift 500 set requires assembly. Set not for use with all Hot Wheels cars. From Mattel.
Hey, hey, hey! It's Bud Howard, and I'm gonna sing a song for you. And Bill's gonna show you a thing or two. You'll have some fun now with me and all the gang.
It's Bill Cosby coming at you with music and fun, and if you're not careful, you may learn something before it's done. So let's get ready, okay?
Hey, hey, hey!
Breakfast in Wonderland is nutritious, tasty, and it's fun!
It's Snap, Crackle, Pop! Start with Snap, Crackle, Pop! Put some Snap, Crackle, Pop into your life! Put Kellogg's Rice Krispies into your morning!
Start your complete breakfast with a good morning sound and taste!
Boy, it is fun!
Yeah, but don't tell Snow White. She'll bring those seven little guys with her.
Put some Snap, Crackle, Pop into your life!
Big Jim's World of Adventure, starring Big Josh with Talking Camp Pack.
Let's make camp here.
You unload the Big Jim sports camper gear. Big Josh says,
bring the boat, I'm fishing gear.
And you know the dinner'll soon be here. Big Josh says,
let's find some firewood.
Now this camp is looking like a good camp should. Big Josh with Talking Camp Pack is sold separately. Big Jim sports camper comes with fishing boat and gear from Mattel.
Now, you tell me your name. Won't talk, huh? Well, how'd you like a knuckle sandwich? What's that? You hear your mother calling you? Come on! Put up your dukes. Put them up. Start talking. I'll rip your head off. Does that remind you of anybody?
I think we all recognize a bully. Pretty tough when he thinks he's got the upper hand. Gang's been getting a hard time from a dude like this named Slappy.
Whip that old
little softball right in here, Harold. You watch Bill put it out of the park.
Hit it this way.
Yeah, come on,
come on, Bill.
Yeah, let's go.
All right, old man. Stick it over here, Bill. Let's go, baby. All right, now. Come on, swing. Swing, batter. Swing.
Hey, look at those clowns, Fungo.
Yeah, Flappy. Look at them. Look at them.
I feel like some laughs. What do you say we pull the old grapefruit trick on him?
yeah, the old grapefruit trick. What's the old grapefruit trick, Slappy?
Come on, I'll show you.
Just screw one right in here. Hey, man, what's the idea?
Stand aside, Slats. I'm gonna give you a little softball pitching lesson.
Yeah, pitching lesson.
Oh, yeah? It's okay, Al. Ain't a pitch alive can get one past old fence-busting Cosby.
Wait. Sorry about that, fence buster.
Okay, Mr. Beanball, put one over the plate. I knocked the cover off it.
Stick it over here.
Come on, quit stalling. Put it in here.
Hey, man, that wasn't too cool. Not cool, huh? Well, how'd you like me to put you and us, String Bean?
Yeah, String Bean.
You keep out of this, you little stooge. Who are you calling a stooge? You take that back. Well, okay this time.
Boy, lucky that Slappy ain't dealing with me. I wouldn't back down like that. Maybe neither, Mamby.
Yeah, you said it.
Hey, when do we play?
We can play as soon as that bad dude Slappy gets off the field.
Hey, Bill, what's all that tutti-frutti stuff on you?
I'll tell you what it is. That Slappy.
Hey, Fat Albert, how you doing, man? Give me a five.
Hey, Slappy, how's the world treating you?
Not very often.
Not very often. That's a good one.
Well, I got a split now. Me and Fungo got to go down to the bakery and feel some coffee cakes.
Yeah, coffee cakes, yeah.
Hey, that Slappy's okay.
He ain't okay. That Slappy's a bad cat.
Huh? Why you bad-mouthing Slappy?
I'll tell you why. Because he pushes smaller dudes around.
And he does mean things.
Mean things like what?
Like pitching grapefruit softballs.
Yeah, like taking the ball from Weird Harold.
Yeah, baby. And be throwing be ferocious be looks at us, but...
Oh, come on now, man. None of this sounds so mean to me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You weren't there.
Neither were you.
Yeah, he
come
don't
on.
Mess with you. Yeah, man, he don't
mess
even mess
with me
with
either.
You won't never be here.
Hey, come on, let's play.
Yeah, free coffee cakes. You're sure funny, Slappy.
Yeah, you know.
Come on, Harold. Groove one.
Hey, Slappy, throw the ball back.
Ball? What ball? Do you see a ball, Fungo?
Yeah, right there. Oh, no, I don't see no ball.
Come on, you big creep. Give me that ball.
Sure, kid. I'll give it to you. Here.
Here's your ball, kid. Hey, get off of me. Let me alone. Hey, Slappy, help.
I'll fix you. Come on, let me have it. You dirty ball stealer.
Hey. Russell, what you doing?
These two creeps got our ball and won't give it back.
Oh, this must be your ball over here. Here you go, Albert. Better keep an eye on the kid. He's a mean dude.
Russell, get off that cat.
But Albert.
You better shape up. Or he ain't gonna play with us no more.
Yeah, play no more.
Okay, Russell, get up and tell him you're sorry.
Fat Albert, they ought to call you Broken Clock.
Broken Clock? Why?
Because you don't know what time it is.
Oh.
cookie beer.
Salerno chocolate chip mini cookies. Have you kids tried them yet? They're tiny and bite-sized and delicious, like all Salerno cookies. Gosh, I finished them all. Better get some more. They come in this bag, and there's more than 350 cookies in it.
Are they really that yummy?
Gosh, yes. They're made by Salerno.
Sherlock, follow your nose. We'll find an adventure. Just follow your nose. I'll ride you, Sherlock, to where your nose goes. Adventure is waiting. Just follow your nose. Sherlock, Sherlock, follow your nose.
Sherlock, a dog you can ride from Romper Room.
Hank Aaron. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Baseball. Hank Aaron Home Run Baseball by Coleco. It's a whole new ball game.
I say so far that Fat Albert's the only one who hasn't seen Slappy for what he is. Now, the only question now is how long can Slappy keep conning his one and only fan?
Hey, Slappy, what are those dudes doing now?
Asking for stitches. That's what they're doing. Hey, dudes, dig me, the world champion of the Junkyard Olympic Roller Ski Jump.
Well, Bill, off the record, Bill. How do you think this year's event shaping up?
Well, Buck, this is a hard one to call. It's up for grabs this year with your new season veterans up against a host of promising youngsters.
Wonderful, Bill. Now up to the ramp, where Rudy's ready to roll. Take it away. Well, Bill, how would you rate that one?
Great form on your takeoff. I have to give Rudy pretty high marks on that one, Buck.
Are you ready for this?
Sure, this is great. Like I said, this is crummy.
Well, Bill, how would you call this one?
With that broom and mop, it ought to be a clean sweep.
This party's pooping out. Let's see if we can liven it up.
Yeah. Liven it up.
Hey, you dudes, you got some kind of deal going on here?
Oh, no. Not again.
Say, Bill, how about showing me and my pal the ropes?
Yeah, the ropes.
Okay, Slappy. What you got up your sleeve?
What? Up my sleeve? I'm clean. We just want to get a close-up look-see at a real pro in action.
Let me go. I gotta make my jump.
You're about to witness the meaning of the word jerk. Oh, oh, stop. Oh, oh.
Baby, what happened, but maybe?
I don't know. But as long as it happened to Slappy, man, it's funny. You?
Huh?
I'm gonna tie your neck in a pretzel knot.
What's the hassle all about?
Really, Bill? Like I was saying, that wasn't too cool, tying that rope around my arm and dragging me down the hill like that.
Me? Tie you?
Hey, that ain't no way. Bill, you shouldn't mess around like that. You okay, Slappy?
Oh, yeah, I'm coming out of it.
What? Wait a minute, you got it backwards.
Lucky for you, Slappy's easy going, man.
Yeah, easy going.
Don't ever do anything mean like that again, Bill.
But Albert...
Sorry about that, Slappy.
I don't carry no grudge. I'll get you, punk.
What kind of spy game you playing?
Shh. He'll hear us.
Who?
Slappy, that's who. He's out to get me.
Oh, come on, man. Slappy wouldn't hurt a fly.
Says you. That Slappy is bad news.
Well, you wouldn't have nothing to worry about if you hadn't pulled that trick on him.
Yeah. I didn't pull no trick on Slappy. Pulled a trick.
Huh? Don't give me that. You the one that's mean.
Fat Albert, you're all wet.
Like I said, Bill, you're mean.
Guess who, punk?
Yeah, guess who?
Hi, Slappy.
Any canaries in your family?
Huh? Canaries?
I heard you singing to Fat Albert. You told him I dropped that bag of water on him. Now you're really gonna get it.
Yeah, get it.
Oh, hi, Fat Albert.
Huh? Where? Where's Fat Albert? Hey, come back here!
Yeah, come back here!
Speak! Come on and speak!
Ribbit!
Okay, one more time!
Ribbit!
You see any signs of him, Russell?
Oh, relax! I'll protect you!
Hey, kid! All right, where's the no good brother of yours?
Good thing he can't hear you. He told me when he was catching up with you, he's gonna turn you inside out.
Oh, yeah?
Ribbit.
Hey, Russell, I don't know you had a little brother.
Yeah.
No class. Give me back my frog. Come on, Slappy, give me. I want my frog, give me.
Cut it out, kid. Oh, no, quit tickling me. I can't stand to be tickled.
Don't you worry, Clyde. He won't hurt you. Will you?
No. No. You got a little unfinished business to take care of.
Yeah, business. Business.
Oh, hi, Fat Albert.
I know you don't. I'm not falling for that one again.
Slappy.
Get away.
Why are you always asking us kids, Slappy?
Because I feel like it, see?
You wouldn't do this to Fat Albert.
That tub of lard don't scare me none.
Slappy,
If Fat Albert was here, I'd tell him a few things.
Hey, what you got to say?
Fat Albert, I was just talking about you.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Hey, Fat Albert, what's happening, man?
Slappy's got a little announcement to make.
Yeah, announcement.
Come on, Slappy. Tell him how you ain't gonna hassle him anymore.
Yeah, hassle him. No more.
Louder.
Louder!
Yeah, louder!
I ain't gonna hassle you no more.
Come on, Albert. Let him have it.
Bopper, Himby, Omba, the Beezer Booby.
Yeah, Albert screaming.
No, please, Albert, don't hurt me, please. Try to understand, I'm the youngest of 15 kids. Ever since I was a little baby, everybody picked on me. I couldn't help myself. But from now on, it's all gonna be different. I promise.
Well, okay. But you hassle the kids once more.
No, I promise. Word of honor.
Come on, Slappy.
Come on,
Slappy.
Give
us our ball.
Ball.
Yeah, man, we want to play.
Yeah, I want to play, too. Come on.
You promised not to hassle us anymore.
I didn't promise you. I promised Fat Albert, and he ain't here.
Yeah, but I'm here. Give me the ball back, Slappy, or else.
Or else what?
Or else this.
Yeah.
Wow, great, man.
How did you
that
do
was
that?
Really together, man.
Yeah, that was
bad.
Yeah,
that was bad.
Wow.
How'd you do that, Russell? What's your secret?
When it comes to hazarding bullies, you just got to have the right touch.
How about that? Trust little old Russell to find Slappy's Achilles heel. If you don't know what that means, ask your folks. Anyway, this has all gotten Slappy to take a good look at himself. He'll think a long time before he starts pushing someone else around. Fat Albert and the gang have learned something from all this, too. And they'll tell you about it in this song.
Attention! Attention! I just want a little attention. You know, it's funny what some people will do for a little attention. They'll roller skate backwards, hang upside down, fall on their head. Yeah. But some people get attention by being mean, and that's a bully. But you know, once you understand what his problem is, you can help him. 'Cause what he really needs is a friend. Just ask him, are you a bully? Ask yourself why. Are you really happy being that kind of guy? You'll never have friends if you're always mean. You'll be the loneliest kid that you've ever seen. 'Cause
This is CBS.